I'm just gonna...
You're just gonna get beat the crap out of.
Fucker.
That's right. Oh my god, look at this. He's got nails in his head.
Fucking fine. Not now, dog. You got a lot of nerve.
Yeah, I think we're both gonna need to help each other out with this one, Woodsman. Get off him. Cool. He's not in a very good state of mind.
Too bad you couldn't protect those whores.
State of body, actually.
Go on! Try to stop me!
Okay. Like that? It's not gonna be that easy. Oh, his axe is right there! What the hell is this thing? He's trying to gore me with that thing. Oh, I impaled him with his own antler. That's gotta smart. Ow. He knows exactly where to hit him.
Hey assholes, I found her.
Thanks for not hitting me with it. I just grabbed something, anything. He looks very dead, but then again, it's a fable, right? Jesus. Should I let him do that?
The magic mirror's missing shard. Where is it?
What was unlocked? Hope you guys don't mind I check this out. This looks like the battle's over, so... Oh, for the woodsman's axe. Ensorcelled by druids. Once just a simple tool for felling trees, the axe became much more when it was ensorcelled by druids and marked with their runes, but... It truly became an object of legend when the woodsman used it to slice the big bad wolf from nave to neck. Protection of little Red Riding Hood. Why can't I speak? It may carry old world charm, but its simplicity of design and quality workmanship make it an effective tool or weapon even today. Okay.
Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything. Do you? What do you have? Nothing.
Well, I am asking you questions.
That useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends.
Where do I find the crooked man?
About who was really running this town?
Where's the crooked man? How can I find him?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot.
Bounces around.
You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Show me Crane's stuff.
Fucking bitch.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back.
You gotta find that magic mirror piece. And we can find him just like Crane did.
Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat.
Pockets. That'd be the longest pocket?
No time for traveler's checks, huh?
Got some money. I'll take it.
He won't be needing this anymore.
Hmm. Too bad we don't know how much money he has. We've been collecting money from various sources lately.
That sick piece of...
Oh, my. Wanking material.
The shard. It's the shard.
Nice. The whole thing, right? It looks smaller.
Hey, Sheriff.
I don't want to fight you again.
Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the Crooked Man wanted them dead. That's all it takes.
Why? Did they know something?
So you can roar smash the place up. Shit. You can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you? Because he ain't in your town. You're in his.
How do you speak like that with no tongue or lip?
Sure as shit is ready for you.
I clicked to hear him out. I guess he didn't have anything else to say.
Out of smoke?
Yeah, I do. That's mine. Give him one. I didn't give Faith one. You'll get one.
Thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Goody grand.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing.
I could tell. You were giving us both a heads up. Glad you didn't hit me, though. That's all I
Jersey
need.
Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something we can do about it.
Avenge them.
Get the fucker who did it.
Yep.
Ain't that the plan?
Yeah, I'm planning on it.
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
All right, we'll go do it then.
Yep, here I go. Doing it. After all this is done, we should take this all this money I found and get myself a car. You gonna be okay?
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
You gonna be all right?
You know me.
Fabletown Business Office, the Woodland Building. Evening.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes.
Ah, not him again.
If he was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in.
Oh,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby.
Entry. Another one for Bluebeard. Oh, did we get Bluebeard before? I think we did. One might think... Bluebeard's money. One might think that Bluebeard donates funds to the Fabletown government for nefarious purposes, seeking special favors or to have a louder voice in government proceedings, but what he really wants is stability and strength. Because, as far as Blackbeard is concerned, Fabletown exists to insulate him from the Mundy world. As much as his money can be a sword, it also serves as a shield. We have an entry for him, yeah, here.
B, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment,
just
please.
Such a blowhard.
Look what I found.
Ta-da!
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
Buffkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Hope it fits. Don't cut yourself.
Finally. Things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been
Thanks.
Gone all day. What did you uncover?
Quite a bit.
I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine. So what else did you find out?
Quick admit.
All right.
Never mind.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Sure. We got a puzzle to do here.
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable.
Screw off until I'm ready.
Why don't you go fuck off until I'm good and ready?
You best to remember that, Bluebeard.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Yeah.
Got me.
We didn't get the whole thing? Did he break it in half?
Where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy. It helps that I have a good working relationship with the mirror.
It was at the
and
lucky
I
pond.
I don't mind speaking in rhyme. So, can you think of anything?
I had a front row seat to a pretty gnarly brawl at the Lucky Pond. When I found it, it was still in Crane's coat. Last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
How would he know we're watching?
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Buffkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
How would he make the mirror piece fit just because he knew where it was? Doesn't make a lot of sense. It doesn't make any sense to me, actually.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
I don't care what they realize.
You need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him.
Pay him?
He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So, just break the news and be done with it, okay?
Oh. I don't want to be telling him that.
Come here. I thought I made myself very clear. I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallet because of you.
Do you know the Crooked Man?
You can't deny that.
Before we get into any of that, what do you know about the Crooked Man?
Don't try to change a subject on me. I need a little bit of that walking around money, you know? My car, total, the gaping mall in my wall, any of us sound familiar? I'm not looking for a handout, just what's right. I need it, Bigby.
It's not my fault.
I didn't throw myself through your wall. I'll ask Woody if you want payback.
You good for nothing, piece of... The woodsman is broke. You saw the way he was living.
Guess I could have given him the money.
In your building.
You know what I mean. Please, I need the money for glamours, Bigby. That's all.
This isn't exactly a new problem with you, Toad.
I would
you
give him the money.
If you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, Is he going to the farm too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst kept secret in Fabletown. For a friend, the rules will bend.
He stays
That's
out of sight.
That's a slope, that is. Colin stays out of sight. For Mondays, at least. Can you say the same?
Fine, I get that. But might I propose a very simple solution? If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just wanna stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest a wash.
How long will it last?
Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only home he knows.
His
old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different. No, it's not right. Burdening the weakest of us like this. This world isn't kind to those of us who can't pass for human.
I'll do what I can.
I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get it sorted, and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
I kinda like the way he looks now. Oh, he hopped! I would give him that money if I had another chance to.
Bluebeard, you wanna talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Oh, now you're leaving? Jeez.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
When we don't want him there, he's there. When I want to talk to him, he leaves.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as...
He's out of our hair for now.
Look, I'll take care of it later. I told him we'd work it out, so he'd get out of our hair. We don't have time to worry about that right now.
Bigby, what did I tell you?
He's unglamored when this whole thing is over. I'll send him to the farm. No questions asked, okay?
Fine. We'll deal with it later.
Snow, remember that.
I should be asking how it got like this.
But
I just
that.
Keep wondering why it happened. To Faith and Lily.
That's what we're trying to find out.
You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons.
I don't know.
Someone did. What would make a person do that?
But we'll find out.
What could those girls have done?
I don't know. But when I catch the fucker who did this, I'll find out why.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
Awesome.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
Good one.
He's
I want to know, too.
He's still waking up a little.
Yeah, I want to see where he's ended up, too.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you.
Paris?
Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey.
Now she's rhyming.
Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
Cancel. Oh, what?
What just... happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right.
That part didn't rhyme.
We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Mirror, mirror.
Mirror, mirror. No time to pout. So, where does Crooked Man hang out?
It's pretty good.
I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
Is it supposed to be upside down?
The door. It moves.
Right.
Yeah. Jersey mentioned that.
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
Flawed statement. I don't know how long that door is going to last, but I'm going to get to it before it changes or whatever he said. How do we know that? How do we know if it just doesn't last like 5 minutes or a minute?
But we have to make a commitment to working within the law.
Bring him back
alive. I'll
catch
him and bring him back here. Alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
The Gothic Bridge, Central Park, 94th Street. night. Who's running? Oh. Bigby is running. Oh, sorry, he wanted to make it to the door in time. So you just open that door and that's where he is? Listen, look.
That's it, all right.
Is that missing cat again? Let's just open it. Oh. Oh, really? So you open the door and there's a portal. Here we go! One way, huh? Does he use a peg leg to walk around?
Tim! What the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff.
Who's Tim?
I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny. Tiny Tim. You'd think I'd have grown that centuries ago.
Okay.
I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
You're expecting me?
Thanks for not giving me a hard time.
Hold on. You've just been waiting for me to show up? You knew I was coming?
That's what they told me. I don't know. They said you made it pretty clear.
I made it pretty clear?
I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do. Please don't make this hard on me. I don't want to get in trouble. Will you just follow me?
Fine.
Yeah, I'll follow
Lead
you.
On.
How did he get involved in all this too, you know? Who's not involved in this in some way? Tiny
Thanks
Tim.
For understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up.
It's all he's here to do. I don't have an entry for him yet.
I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard. Or an escort, for that matter.
It's dangerous for you here.
I was a little surprised myself when they asked me to do it. I thought it was a joke, actually.
You shouldn't be here, Tim. This place is dangerous. Especially for someone like you.
It's not like that. Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like.
He's
gave
crooked.
Me a job. And I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got.
Just well, then it's not an option.
Keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is going to get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good.
Working here
so
means...
I hope you two can come to an understanding.
Means you're involved.
Don't you realize you're not just minding the door? You work for that crooked bastard, your hands get dirty, too.
It's not so bad.
Not so bad? Are you fucking blind, Tim? He's a murderer.
So you're telling me you agree with everything Crane does?
Crane doesn't murder people.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Can't you just wait up, Sheriff? Hold on.
All right, I'll wait.
Thanks.
Am I some kind of a fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah? Mate, I ain't scared of you.
You first.
Go ahead. You got a job to do.
You needn't worry.
I recognize the voice, though.
Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Yeah. Puddin' Pie. Georgie Porgy. Oh. We both are Tweedles here. Could have killed one of you. Oh, here's a Jersey Devil, but I didn't.
Thank you, Tim.
Eager for a rematch.
I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort.
Oh my god.
But you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
I don't like to look at the skin under his skin by his eye.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill.
Does he now? Let's look up Tiny Tim. Or Crooked Man. Or both. Oh, three of them. Let's look up Tiny Tim first. Tiny Tim, Sentry. While most fables theorize that their longevity and overall well-being is improved by the Mundi world's knowledge of them, for a select few, that does not seem to apply. When a malady or injury is an integral part of a fable story, that notoriety can make recovery nearly impossible. That's what Tiny Tim thinks, at least. And no medical care or magic, rather none that he can afford, can heal his leg. The Crooked Man, Crime Lord. The Crooked Man has slowly built himself into one of the most powerful figures in Fabletown. His operation started with a crooked sixpence and a crooked house, two things he cared about more than his wife or children, whom he killed rather than let them stand in his way. Brother. And Tiny Tim says he's not so bad. He killed his own wife and children. In his rise, the Crooked Man has ensnared many fables in his criminal web, providing them what they need, but always at a high cost. He is cunning, pervasive, and ruthless. And finally, the Crooked Lair, headquarters. Occupying a desanctified church. Well, I didn't ask Tim where we were, so I guess that's what he would have told us. This is just one of the many locations the Crooked Man's operation uses to run the Fabletown underworld. Its lounge atmosphere makes for a comfortable meeting place, unless you are an unwelcome guest. It is completely boarded up to the outside world, and the only way in is through one of the many portals marked by a door with the Crooked Man's Catherine Wheel icon, scattered throughout the city and elsewhere. Kind of reminds me of the marks from the Thieves Guild and Elder Scrolls.
You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it.
Yeah, what they need. Bang.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
I didn't realize what's her name is here too. All right. Let's talk. I see I'm kind of outnumbered here.
All right. You got me here. Let's talk.
Shortest episode yet. They're getting shorter and shorter.
I've heard stories about you.
Oh, yeah? Two of them.
In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh,
pigs?
Screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses.
Are you talking about the three little pigs?
Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it.
Yeah, well, too damn bad.
Oh, well.
Oh. That's what's coming next episode. Okay. Next and final episode. Did you send Colin to the farm? 85.5% of players decided Colin should not go to the farm. Did you attempt to remove Nerissa's ribbon? 63.8% of players did not try to remove the ribbon. Good, because she probably would be dead now. Which crooked operation did you investigate first? 63.2% of players went to the cut above first. Yeah, for the beasts and beauty's sake. Did you send Toad to the farm? 73% of players decided Toad should not go to the farm. How did you respond to the Crooked Man? Really? 41.8% of players agreed to talk with him first. The rest threatened him or attacked him or something? Doesn't say. Wow. So we have one more episode to go. I'm guessing, let's see if I call it correctly, it's going to be another three episodes. It's just over an hour and a half long. I wish they were all like 2.5 hours long, like the first one. Oh well. A original force. Kid Beyond. Melissa Hutchinson, I believe, did the voice of what's her name? Clementine? On the Walking Dead series? So in a minute, when this is over, I'm gonna double check my Fable entries. I think we missed at least two. So, I can see Tiny Tim's, I can see what he's saying. That they need him, but it's at a price that's too high. It's their freedom. People are suffering. People are dying. People are basically slaves. So we can't have that. There's got to be a better way. Plus, we can't have crime. So I can't agree with that. But is he going to go up against the entire room? Well, not the entire room, but the Jersey Devil wants to fight him. And there's the two Tweedles there. I don't think Georgie Porgy is a threat at all. But you never know. He might have a gun with him or something. And what's her name? The girl there, his assistant. She's not going to be a problem. But we still... I mean, I don't know if the Crooked Man himself is a problem. Bloody Mary doesn't seem to be there. I didn't see her there. But I really don't... Yeah, he's not in the best of shape to be going against Tweedledum, Tweedledee, and the Jersey Devil, at the very least. Alright, nothing new here. Yeah, we're missing two. I do like the sound, though. Ka-clunk, ka-clunk. So I want to thank you guys for watching, as always, and see you in the next episode for the finale, Chapter 5, the last chapter. Always, seek adventure.